It will be surprising to know that deforestation could be perceived as one strong possible root cause of this global chaos, the deadly spread of novel coronavirus COVID-19. The pandemic of novel coronavirus has led to a global scale chaos, from rapidly increasing fatalities to crumbling economies, lockdown of several countries to empty shopping aisles. We are all now living in a world which we never thought would exist in our lifetimes. The majority of new diseases affecting humans are zoonotic, meaning that they originate in wild animals, mostly mammals, and then cross over to humans. It is important to know that novel coronavirus is a virus of the corona family, whose members were also responsible for the deadly epidemics like SARS, severe acute respiratory syndrome, and MERS, Middle East respiratory syndrome. So how exactly did all this start in the December of 2019? Let's take a quick rewind. In the year 2002, bats carried the SARS virus. They transmitted to civet cats, which were sold in some Chinese markets as food, and hence they found their way into the human world. In 2012, bats also had the MERS virus. They transmitted this to camels, and since Middle East is full of them, we had the Middle East respiratory syndrome. Now let's talk about COVID-19, the novel coronavirus. As you already know, as per the latest researches, bats when tested carried this particular strain of COVID-19 virus, which matched about 96%, which is a huge number. And it is not very surprising. While Huanan market does include bats caged along with other animals like pangolins, which are suspected to be the possible direct cause of human infection, it is not appropriate to isolate this particular pandemic to that market alone. It should be noted that the population of bats is in billions, larger than that of human population. In fact, they make up 1/5 of Earth's mammal population, second largest, right after rodents. They are there everywhere, except for Antarctica. Since they travel in huge groups and often share caves and hollowed out trees, they are bound to carry a lot of viruses, not just corona, a lot. So, it shouldn't surprise you to know that they have a significant role in other epidemics too, like rabies, Nipah virus, Ebola, etc. etc. Our world's only flying mammal flies a lot. When it flies, its body temperature spikes to over 100 degrees Fahrenheit and the heart rate is more than 1000 beats per minute. While for other mammals this means death, same is not the case with bats. Here is where it gets very interesting, as this involves a miraculous evolution of this ancient mammal bird. When any body is attacked with any virus, its immediate first response is to fight it off until it gets rid of it. While the immunity is busy doing that, the body itself falls sick as symptoms develop. Sometimes these symptoms themselves are so fatal that the body could just give up even before the fight is complete. This is a natural process. But looks like nature nudged these mammals a little more, as they are more evolved than they were ever before. The flying distance of bats has largely increased due to deforestation and human colonizing. Their food sources have become farther and they are having to fly 30 to 50 miles overnight. Immunity of bats, however, is much higher than that of humans, and so viruses like COVID-19 are not life-threatening to them. So when bats pick up these viruses, they have tamed their immunity system such that their body doesn't overreact and instead coexist with these viruses without letting the virus kill them. As a result, bats don't often fall sick, as in exhibit symptoms, but they do fly around carrying these multiple viruses that they pick up in dark, hollow places. So basically, they co-evolve with these viruses and bugs that don't really harm them. Virus is not really a living thing like bacteria, since it has no cellular structure. Its only motive is to find a host and strengthen itself. So when the excretions of these bats, like blood, mucus, saliva, urine, or fecal matter, is exposed to other animal or a human, the virus rapidly spreads. The global spread of these viruses is sometimes slow, or sometimes it spreads at an alarming rate. Sometimes the virus doesn't even result in a symptom in the host, or sometimes it even kills the host. What happens when or why depends on a wide variety of factors. Patient zero of Wuhan is one good example for this. If you want to know more about how the virus spread globally, let me know in the comments and I'll get that done for you. Certain wildlife animals rarely mix with each other, but due to human intervention, when they are found next to each other or on top of each other in cages, how nature responds is an unknown factor. It is not natural, period. Before you wish and pray for bats to disappear from this planet, let me remind you how catastrophic that would be, since they have been a major contributor to the life on this planet since 50 million years. That would mean the insect population will alarmingly increase, the use of pesticides will exponentially increase, mosquitoes will be swarming on the planet, and the chaos is of an even bigger global scale. Yes, bigger than the coronavirus pandemic. There are multiple researchers in the world who are currently studying how bats' immunity works so that we can learn a lesson or two from them. All it must have taken was one bat to transmit this virus to humans and lock down the entire world. But imagine how the rapidly changing climate could be contributing to evolutionary changes in other species behind the scenes. While the glaciers melt, they are releasing a vast amount of trapped bacteria, fungus and viruses into the seas, impact of which will not be known to us, at least not yet, because those glaciers are a lot more than just frozen ice. If this is your first time on Indianistic, please do subscribe and ring the bell to get notified as and when a new video is uploaded. Stay on and watch more videos on Indianistic. Wash your hands, maintain social distance, self-quarantine yourself and stay safe. Even if you don't have any symptoms, it is important that you do all the above, since we must care for the elderly and the world.